Good afternoon. We begin with breaking news. Daniel Andrews, Victoria's long-serving and controversial Premier, has quit. He delivered the political bombshell at a Snap media conference this afternoon and backflipping on a promise to see out his third term. Mr. Andrews declaring, when it's time, it's time.
It's not an easy job, being Premier of our state. That's not a complaint, that's just a fact. It requires 100% from you and your family. That, of course, is time limited, and now is the time to step away. The only way that I know how to do this job is to have it consume me, to have it define me. To a certain extent, every waking moment is about the work, and that takes a toll.
He'll step down from the job at 5 p.m. tomorrow after the Labor caucus votes on a replacement. Well, the timing of today's announcement even shocked those in the know. Nine's Reid Butler, who's at Victoria State Parliament. Reid, was there any indication that the Premier was going to call it a day?
Well, no, Mark, not really. Not in the immediate future, at least. He is Victoria's longest-serving Labor Premier with three election wins under his belt. So it is around that time where leaders sometimes do decide to stand down. But as you say, the Victorian Premier had been very steadfast in his claims that he would see out this term at least and likely continue on after the next election as well. So this was a surprise for everybody. The hastily organised media conference, about 40 minutes' notice to get up here to Spring Street at Victoria's State Parliament, then the announcement that Premier Daniel Andrews would be stepping down. Not quite effective immediately, but effective tomorrow afternoon at 5 o'clock. He was a little emotional during his address. His voice was wobbling. He was flanked by his wife, Kath, and his cabinet ministers. He said he made this decision only recently following discussions with his family. Interestingly, this was his response when asked why the backflip on his claims that he would stick out his term. Have a look.
It was true then, and I've changed my mind. The moment you are thinking about what you're going to do next, what life would be like if you were not in this role, you owe it to the people you love, you owe it to the people you serve, and frankly, you owe it to yourself to make the difficult but important decision to move on and give somebody else the amazing privilege to work hard every day for the people of this great state. That's why I've changed my mind.
Reid, Dan Andrews is best described as polarising. He upset a lot of people during your numerous lockdowns. What's the reaction been like?
Well, there's a lot of people very happy at this announcement. A lot of people still hurting after those lockdowns, the most brutal in the country and the longest in the world. Also recently, a lot of anger has been being felt among the public here in Victoria following the Victorian government's decision to pull the pin on the Commonwealth Games here in the state at great taxpayers' expense. I think it was around $380 million. That was certainly bruising for the government. There's a perception as well that Daniel Andrews is arrogant and can behave like a bully, but you can't ignore the fact that he has convincingly won three state elections, including last year, where it was described as a landslide. So there is certainly still a lot of support for the Premier here in Victoria, Mark.
I have a new Premier at 5 p.m. tomorrow. Any idea yet who that will be?
It is looking like it will be Jacinta Allan, the Deputy Premier, close factional ally of Premier Daniel Andrews. The decision will be made tomorrow. It is certainly a huge story, though. This is one that is going to keep on giving over the next few weeks, you would imagine.
OK, Reid, thanks for joining us. Well, 2GB Drive presenter Chris O'Keefe joins me now. Chris, you covered the pandemic for Nine, so you watched how each of the leaders handled the crisis. Do you think he handled that well?
I think Australia was poorer for having Dan Andrews sitting in National Cabinet, to be quite frank with you, Mark. And you just look at his legacy. 260-odd days, Melbourne was locked down over six lockdowns. 260-odd days, the most lockdown city in the entire world. Second to it was Buenos Aires, for God's sake. And people are there doing like backflips with Dan Andrews' premiership, saying that he was a good premier. Now, leaving aside the lockdowns in and of themselves, you had elective surgeries cancelled. You had cancer patients unable to visit family members. You had Dan Andrews, who bungled a hotel quarantine program that let COVID into Australia in the first place. And he stood there at these long-winded press conferences, simply fobbing off any legitimate criticism from the citizens of Victoria. And he almost gaslighted them in a way, saying that I am good for you. What we are doing here is good for you, so you must support me along here. And the fact that then that attitude infected itself in the National Cabinet, I think, spread this crazy megalomania across the country, and Australia was worse off for it.
Chris Albo, who once shared a flat with Daniel Andrews, has just described Andrews as a man of great conviction and enormous compassion. I would doubt that 100% of the Victorian population agrees with him.
Well, they keep electing him, though. So what are we supposed to do? We sit here in Sydney, and everyone else in the country sort of looks down to Victoria and goes, what are you doing down there, guys? This doesn't make any sense. And this is what really sort of annoys me about the Labor Party, is that they lionise their political figures simply because they win elections. Not what they do for human beings, not what they do for the citizens. The one and only thing that matters to the Australian Labor Party is winning elections. And on that score, Dan Andrews has been a wild success. He'll go down as a Labor hero. But if you look at his record, he came in 2014, Dan Andrews. Net debt in Victoria, how's this for a start? $25 billion it was when he became Premier. You know what it is now? $135 billion. To the point where Andrews is now slapping land tax on schools to try to claw some of that back. You're seeing things like the Commonwealth Games, $380 million taxpayer money that's now being thrown towards the Commonwealth Games that didn't happen. What about every time you fly into Melbourne, you're looking around, where's the train? Well, Dan Andrews promised a train when he thought that he was in a bit of trouble before the last election. $10 billion he was going to spend on a train from Melbourne Airport into the city. Well, he's cancelled that too. So if you have a look at his legacy and you have a look at his record, it is anything but flash, Dan Andrews. And I think the rest of the country can now have a look down south and say, hey, guys, thank God he's going. And can you please elect a Premier who has some sort of idea of what it means to be humble, and a bit of humility in politics goes a long way.
Chris, I've got a mate in Victoria who just texted me, and he's having a party tomorrow at 5 o'clock because he's so happy Dan Andrews is getting out. You touched on it before. Look, he did alienate so many people, but was there anything good to come out of the Daniel Andrews regime?
Well, outside of the fact that he managed just to continue winning elections, and if you're a Labor Party member, of course you think it's a good thing. And look, I will say this, they've got a huge representation of women in the Daniel Andrews cabinet. That wasn't the case when he first came to power, so kudos for him for that. And they do have a pretty serious women's health policy down in Victoria that I think is probably the envy of the nation. But to be honest, that's about it. He's talking about plans for building 800,000 homes across the state. You know, good luck with that. Everyone has got a plan. Well, let's see how it becomes a reality. I think ultimately Dan Andrews will be remembered for his arrogance, his pig-headedness, his refusal to even understand or indulge any criticism from other people, legitimate criticism. He just fobbed it off and it was his way or the highway. And I think you will see now, if the Liberal Party in Victoria can get their act together, surely they're a shot at the next Victorian election, which is still many, many years away. But nonetheless, he'll get the bronze statue. Don't worry about that, Dan Andrews. And I reckon he'll be the first one out there polishing it up, making sure it looks nice and shiny.
Chris, have to leave it there. Thanks for your time.
Thanks, Mark.
Adapto man who faked his own kidnapping will spend New Year's Eve with his mistress has escaped prison today. Instead, he'll have to compensate police $16,000 for wasting their time and has been handed a community corrections order, the magistrate labelling the plan as abhorrent behaviour. We'll have more on this story from our reporter a little later on. Well, firefighters and police are still this afternoon at the scene of an appliance factory fire in Canterbury, working to determine what caused the massive blaze. Marcelia Eiley has more.
The fire has been contained, but crews are right now trying to tackle a potential asbestos risk that might be inside this building. It all started at around 2:30 this morning when flames erupted through ABCO Appliance Services here on Canterbury Road in Canterbury, just metres from a service station holding more than 100,000 litres of petrol. It took more than 70 firefighters around 3 hours to bring this blaze under control. Canterbury Road was closed for most of the evening as fireys tackled this blaze, but many of those lanes were reopened at around 6:30 this morning, with only one westbound lane remaining closed. No one has been injured or was inside at the time, but the owner was here this morning. He was interviewed by detectives and tells us he's simply shocked and lost for words to see 50 years of his life's work down the drain. Many other neighbouring business owners are equally as shocked. We spoke to them a little earlier. Take a listen to what they had to say.
I just came out and looked. So it was like a huge smoke coming out from the rooftop. So we were all like panicked.
How much petrol do you have there? What would have happened if that spread?
Close to 100,000 litres under the ground. You know what that is? That would be a good popcorn.
Crews have sprayed the building with a red substance which they hope will suppress those asbestos particles. And it's only once that risk is evaded that they'll be able to enter this building and begin their investigation into how this fire started.